Hey everybody, I'm Alabama Boss. It's time for another episode of Uncurrent Events. Okay, this one takes us to London, where there's a new craze with middle-aged women. You know how women like to get together and hang out and have like little tea parties and stuff on Sundays or the weekend? Well, these women in London are eating brie cheese. That's a fancy cheese. But they're putting a little something in the cheese to make the party more exciting. They're putting MDMA, Molly. They're getting f***ed up. But these ladies are calling this breeing, and they're saying that it makes their gathering together a lot better. No s***. You all just took Molly. Look, I'm not saying you should go out and add drugs to your party to make your party better, but you know, that's kind of the idea. I'm gonna quote this lady here. This is what she said. The 50-year-old businesswoman says, "I have a strong circle of female friends, and we had all tried the latest fads, food, fashions, and destination dinner parties, but something was missing." She says they didn't seem to laugh as much as they did when they were younger, and their parties had kind of got stale, so they decided to spice it up. This is where the story gets really interesting, to me at least. One of her friends said, "Hey, my daughter has some MDMA. She says that it'll make our party better." But they had no idea how to take it. So what do you do when you don't know how to take your drugs? You phone your son. So her son tells her, "Don't snort it, you gotta eat it." So what do? They say, "Hey, let's wrap it in some brie cheese and eat it." Boy, I see it, 50-year-old, some of these women are divorced or widowed, they're having a good time. I'm not knocking it, but I'm not gonna be doing it. I don't see me sitting around on Sunday breeing with the boys. All right, this one takes us to Pennsylvania, where there's a school that's put a new policy in place. This policy makes the kids smile. I'm not saying it makes them smile because they have a comedian on site. It's one where they have to smile. When they're walking up and down the halls, you better be smiling. So these students that have to go to school by law, because if they don't, their parents will go to jail, have to now smile walking down the hall. And if they don't smile, they get sent to the guidance counselor who will talk to them about their problems. And if they don't talk about their problems, they get detention. This is a really shitty situation. Look, you're forced to go to school. Why be forced to smile? You don't like being there. Yeah, sometimes it's fun, but a lot of times it sucks. Now you're being forced to smile, and if you don't smile, you're punished. This policy was put in place as a part of some anti-bullying campaign. I mean, it's very ironic that this anti-bullying campaign is bullying, because you're forcing these students to smile when they don't have to. The kids don't have to smile all day at school. They only have to smile when they go between classes. That is the rule. You have to smile every time you walk up and down the hall. It doesn't matter what's going on, you better be smiling. I would have been in so much trouble if this was a rule when I was in school. I was pissed off 75% of the time. And if I wasn't, I was doing something else that I shouldn't be doing that was making me smile. All of these teenage boys are getting the strip club effect in high school. All the girls want me. Okay, this one takes us to the great state of Florida, the gift that keeps on giving. The cops have came to this residence to arrest a lady because of failure to appear in court. So when the cops go to the door, they know she's there because they've been tipped off that this lady is home. So her boyfriend tells the cops she's not here, but they know she's there. The reason they know she's there is because someone tipped them off. They saw him stuffing her into a plastic tote. And you may be saying, how did he stuff her in a plastic tote? Well, she don't have any legs. So this man hid his girlfriend that has no legs in a Rubbermaid container. So she was wanted for failure to appear. I'm gonna read to you what she was charged with and what she should have went to court for. Armed kidnapping, obviously she has arms. Aggravated assault with a deadly weapon on law enforcement officer. Aggravated assault with a deadly weapon and false imprisonment charges. Look, keep in mind, this woman's missing two legs and committed all these other crimes without her legs. She's somebody you don't mess with. I would love to know whose idea it was to hide in the plastic tote. I mean, did her boyfriend have the balls to tell this ruthless woman, "Hey, you'll fit in that container since you don't have legs anymore"? Or did she say, "Hey, bitch, put me in that tote and don't tell them I'm here"? I'm thinking the latter. So the boyfriend tells the cops that she's not there, but she eventually surrenders as he resists arrest. And I'm thinking she probably surrendered because she was running out of air. Honestly, you get stuck in one of those things, some of them are airtight. "Let me out, I can't breathe." Okay, this one right here takes us to Arizona, where we have a little bit of a love story, at least for one person. And if any of y'all out there do the online dating, you may want to pay attention. So these two people meet online, and they go on one date. Only thing is, the girl fell in love, and she proceeds to send this guy text messages. She ends up sending him upwards of 65,000 text messages. She sent him up to 500 text messages a day. Look, there's different levels of crazy, and this right here is off the charts batshit crazy. One of the messages said something about bathing in his blood. He was out of the country, and his home surveillance caught her going in and out of his house, taking a bath, and when they found this woman, she had a butcher knife in the passenger seat of her car. So she was probably gonna cut his dick off. The text messages kind of went south after he caught her on his property or parked outside of his house, and he called the law to her, and they escorted her off. After that, she started sending him the messages about, "I am the new Hitler, I want to bathe in your blood," and a lot of really creepy, dark messages. "I want to bathe in your blood. I am the new Hitler. Don't leave me or I'll kill you. I love you. P.S. Bye." The court document says that she didn't want to hurt the man and sent the threatening text messages because she didn't want him to leave. I believe this woman honestly thought that she could scare this guy into not leaving her, which they wasn't even together. They went on one date. She did eventually get arrested, and right now she's being held without bond. But she will get out. Keep that in mind. If you're out in Arizona or you play around on Tinder, think twice before you swipe right. Okay, this one takes us back to Florida, because there's always stories in Florida, where there's an ag science teacher that has drowned two raccoons. In this ag class, they have some livestock, like a lot of ag classes do. So the ag teacher had these chickens, and some raccoons are getting in the chickens. He decides to catch them in a live trap, which most people do. Where he messes up is he decides to kill the raccoons. How's he kill them? He decides to invite the entire middle school to come and watch him drown them in a garbage can. And he tells them, don't video this, which is signal for get your phones out, it's about to go down. Common sense was not used here. You're at school, you're teaching kids about ag farm life, and yes, this type of thing goes on farms. But you're not at a farm. You are at school. That's where I think this guy messed up. He may be a great ag teacher. Some things that happen on a farm cannot happen at school. If you have a nuisance raccoon, you can't drown it in a garbage can. Now you have a teacher on paid leave, a bunch of pissed off parents, and some kids that have learned some lessons about farm life that are keeping them up all night. Well, that's all I got this week on Uncurrent Events. I'm Alabama Boss and ready to rent. Y'all have a good one.